Hi and welcome to the People's Republic of Brighton and Hove that is filmed live in the People's Republic Towers.
Republic Towers?
Yeah, we have towers.
Do we?
Yeah, we're getting that big.
We've got an I-360 tower. Is that where we're in? It's not.
It's not.
We
our
should
Republican
be coming
tower.
To you from our radio station. You know that from the radio show.
I was just trying to mix it up.
Oh, brilliant. You're so amazing. Talking about amazing, do we have an amazing show for these lovely people this evening?
The show tonight is one of the best lineups I think I've ever seen.
Oh, great. Tell us about it.
Well, I'm very pleased to welcome Darren here today from the Crew Club.
I can't get
my words out today.
Well, let me take over. Darren from the Crew Club. I'm actually pretty excited about this because the Crew Club is ace. Second half, who's in the second half?
We've got Lizzie. Do you know where Lizzie's from?
I know. I'm curious about this.
We've got Lizzie Curious talking about her Pride gig.
All right.
In the second half of the show today.
So you're going to have to stay for that. But whilst you're here, let's bring Darren on.
Fantastic. Sounds like a plan.
Darren, welcome to the People's Republic of Brighton and Hove TV show, radio show for TV.
Hello.
Hello.
How are you doing? You
know, I'm all right, yeah.
We ought to ask Darren a question so that he can answer and tell us about why he's here.
Go ahead.
Well, we've dragged you in because I know you're connected with the Crew Club.
Yeah.
In a nutshell, could you tell us what the Crew Club is and why I'm such a fanboy?
Okay, so the Crew Club is a youth and community centre for people living in East Brighton. It's been around since 1999. Came about because a young person lost their life on the estate, so we looked to provide a safe space for young people. Over the years, that's evolved into a new 21st century youth and community centre.
Nice.
It's a separate build, isn't it? It was built specially, is that right?
Yeah, so when we set this up, we was in a disused porter cabin, which used to be used for an after-school club. Yeah. And wasn't used for a few years. So took a bit of persuading and the council eventually let us use it. So we had 30, 40 kids using it on a regular basis. And then the next phase was that the regeneration project came to East Brighton, which was a Labour government initiative called New Deal for Communities.
Okay.
So over the 10 years, roughly when in that 10-year span did that money come in that you could build the...
So the money came in 2000 with a 10-year spending plan.
Okay.
But the 10-year spending, the spending plan lasted 7 years, but the regeneration plan lasted 10 years.
Yeah.
So we were fortunate enough within that cycle to draw in revenue and capital, with the capital being to build the new centre. Yeah.
And it is a great new centre.
Yeah, I was saying, I've heard so many amazing things from different people, different organisations about the Crew Club. And you said children and young people, so what kind of age range do you work with?
Yeah, so now, so when we first started, it was more teenagers, because obviously the incident affected a teenager, and it was about kind of working with the peer group. Over the years, we've widen that to all ages. So we have work that works with parents and toddlers, and we also put on Christmas parties for the older members of the community. So it's all ages, really.
Do you get a mixing of the older people and the younger?
Yeah, so if you take the Christmas party, the young people put on an event and a show for the older people. Got to be careful what I call older people these days. you're not allowed to call older people old anymore, so the senior members of the community. But
and experienced members of the community.
They sign up literally after the event for the next year, so it's definitely
something that they
enjoy attending. Mm. And for some of those people, it's the main thing that they attend that time of year, which it's quite nice to be able to get them out and socialising with other people and just having some fun at that time.
Am I right in thinking that the Crew Club has made quite an impact in the area, you know, since that nasty incident back in 1999?
Yeah, massive impact. So just in its early stages, crime levels, for instance, dropped 30% within the first couple of years.
Wow.
So it had a massive impact on crime. I think what you'll find now is that the crime levels aren't as high as people might think they should be or are.
Yeah.
But what it is the issues that affect the community now are kind of more around kind of the like education and kind of health. Mm. And so what we're trying to do is impact people's lives in those areas so that it kind of has an impact on them like over generations.
Yeah.
Hence the stuff you're doing, because you were saying to me just before that, you know, you were attending a 5K run for mums.
So we set up a 5K project for mums, just basically working with them over 10 weeks. I was part of a team that set up East Brighton Park Run. So we've got a park run in East Brighton Park.
Yeah.
And so the 10th session of the 5K project will be to run the 5K park run. We're in started our fourth week this morning. And the group's doing really well. And so it was quite a milestone this morning because they've basically just moved from running twice as much but having twice as less recovery time. So it's quite a milestone for some people that haven't, wouldn't normally run. So a massive achievement for the group. And the determination in them is just so nice to see.
Yeah.
You know, it's I'd say up until this point, it was small steps. This morning, it was quite a big step. So they're doing really well.
How many have got involved? And did you have any trouble getting them to do this, to actually get involved in this way?
We've got 9 or 10 involved in this project.
Right.
It's always difficult to get people involved in projects that are around sort of, you know, health and well-being because people don't, and this isn't a White Hawk issue, this is generally an issue. It's like people don't want to be told that they're unhealthy, and there's a balance between trying to help people get healthier and not kind of focusing on all the things that they see as the things that hold them back.
Yeah.
So what's good with this group is that they are a group that would normally not do this sort of activity.
Yeah. Right.
So they are doing it, so they can now kind of help others in the next cycle and also kind of talk about their experience on it, because one thing that they've found is that they are really enjoying it, although it's tough. They are really enjoying it, so
I was going to ask you what the secret was, and you've given it away. It's fun, isn't it? You kind of get
you've got to find things that people enjoy doing and that they see as a social activity as much as a kind of health benefit. Because if it's seen as something that they have to go out of their way to do, it's like a chore sort of thing. It's kind of, it's not sustainable.
Yeah.
So by the fact that they've gelled well together as a group, so they're supporting each other, it's really nice to watch it evolve and develop.
So with your membership and the content that you do, because I've seen some stuff on Facebook around doing sort of healthy snacks for kids.
Yeah, so Safe Start Project, which is 7 to 11-year-olds, every session has a healthy food sort of offer alongside it.
But do you sit down and go, right, this is what healthy food is? Or do you kind of sit down and do discovery?
Again, it's not about kind of trying to tell people what they're not doing. It's about trying to introduce things into people's lives so they can see, taste stuff, try stuff, and then they can make an informed choice if they want to continue with that. But
that's great. So just to be clear, this is really just for people in the East Brighton area, is that right? Or
well, we certainly don't exclude people from the rest of the city, but I think what we're trying to do with our work is focus on people from the BN25 area, which is what we're calling it, and particularly those that are kind of in a BN25.
Yeah.
So, you know, the statistics show that they're the people likely to be worse off in the city. So, you know, we're an organisation based in that area. I've grown up and lived there all my life, so that, you know, what I want to see changed is people's lives in that area.
So, and growing up there, you've seen a lot of people move in, is that right?
There's definitely a big change of demographic. There's more diversity, which is great. You know, we provide services for everyone, but that doesn't mean everyone wants to take up our services. So, you know, we know that we're not interacting with, you know, the whole community, but we're trying to interact with as many of those people in that community as we can.
This is the thing I really liked about, one of the reasons why I'm so enthused that you're here, is the whole thing about you're embracing these new people who are moving in and they're being welcomed into that community.
Yeah.
Is there a challenge there that you have a...
There's not a challenge from our perspective. I think there's just a challenge for people to get involved with stuff. Right. You know, so again, it's any community. It's like some people really keen to get involved and some people are likely to just, you know, stay behind closed doors and just get on with life. There's enough to be doing with just normal life, let alone community stuff. So But opportunities are there, and if people do want to get more involved with what we're doing, then they're more than welcome to come and see what we're doing, and we can look at opportunities for that.
So your doors are open?
Always, yeah.
So do you want, in the last minute, do you want to give us just a rundown of where you're based, and is there anyone else that's kind of working with you on this project?
Yeah so we are based in the old, on the old white oak football pitches.
Okay.
So it's basically the bottom of the race hill, so people that know the race course.
Mm.
We've got a number of projects running, so we're setting up a new football infrastructure with White Oak Football Club.
Okay.
So we're now the official youth setup.
Oh, nice.
For White Oak FC, and that's in partnership with obviously White Oak Football Club and also Police & Co, which is a local company. And you know, the Met College linked in there somewhere. So we're
sorry to do this, Darren. Thank you very much.
Brilliant.
Fascinating to hear about it. Come back after the break because, well, we'll be here. Well, I won't, but we'll be here.
Welcome back to Laces TV's number one show. I'm gradually melting. How about you, Debs?
I'm not melting, no.
Oh, OK. That's fine. As long as you're all right.
I'm absolutely fine.
What we need is someone cool.
We do.
To cool the stand.
We're not. So
yeah. Who do you know that's cool?
We are going to move very swiftly on to the guest for the second half of the show. It's a return guest. She's
wow,
come back.
She came
we
back.
Didn't put her off. It is the fabulous Lizzie Curious.
Like Hello. A boomerang, she came back. Hi, Lizzie. Love to see you.
Thank
Lovely
you.
To see you indeed. So please tell us what wonderful things you've come to talk about.
Well, I've come to talk to you both about my upcoming club night, which is on the 6th of July at a fab new venue, and have a little chat with you about Pride and all the other things I love about Brighton.
Oh, which...
oh well, where do we begin? With
Start
that?
With where's the venue? Which
so,
venue?
Yes, Saturday the 6th of July, I help to run a party called Bad Dog, which is a house music night, and we really love what we do. We love bringing all sorts of people who love house music together. Mm-hmm. Our nights are really fun, and as you can probably guess from my attire, very colourful and all about like good vibes. And on Saturday the 6th of July, we're doing a special neon glow party.
Ooh.
So we're gonna have neon face paints. We're encouraging everyone to wear like bright neon colours, maybe something like this, or UV, so white looks really good under UV light. And we'll have lots of like lights, and as in like handheld glowing lights, as well as the club nights. Lights. And yeah, we did a similar party in Hove on New Year's Eve, and it was really popular. And ever since then, everyone's been saying, oh, when are you going to do another glow party?
Wow.
And this new venue we've got is perfect for it.
So tell us a bit about this new venue, because it's not a venue I've heard of.
Yeah, it's really new, actually. It's called Door 77. It's right in the heart of Brighton, formerly known as Bow Wow.
Okay.
Closed for a couple of months, reopened. It's got an amazing interior. It has these futuristic, well, they're not futuristic, because they're here now. But you could imagine that they would be futuristic. Anyway, amazing lights that kind of shoot up from across the stage and across the whole of the club.
Wow.
That are all programmed with different colours, so you could have like a rainbow of lights coming across, or like black and white strobe. It's really great. It's got a great sound system. So from my point of view as a DJ, I love that. But it's also really nice for the crowd as well. And it's all, because it's new, it's just got like, it's just really well designed. So it's great for dancing. It's got a lovely drinking area with lovely seats as well. And we love it. So very much looking forward to being there.
So house music, right? So
that's right.
I'm very old, so I remember.
No.
I don't remember house music. Well, I don't remember lots. So there was house music in the 90s. The stuff you do, is it modern house music?
Well, I generally play a mixture of the tracks that I'm absolutely loving right now, but also a lot of remixes of the classics.
Wow.
So classic tunes from the 90s, from the 2000s, from the last decade, and then I'm also always working on my own material as well.
Yes.
So I usually sneak a couple of curious remixes or tracks into.
I love that about it. You're sneaking your own stuff in. That's great.
Because I don't remember
this bit.
You don't just play the music; you make the music as well, because you are a recording artist.
That's correct. Yes. Yeah, I'm very lucky to be able to write my own music and then play it in the clubs to people. It's really, a dream come true. So I do my productions. I also collaborate with a lot of artists as well, and I also write a lot of top lines to go on other tracks as well as on my own music as well.
Fantastic. Can I ask, is this a ticketed event?
Yes, we are selling tickets online now. Just search for Bad Dog Brighton on Facebook and you'll find them. And if you're not a Facebooker, just go to baddog.co.uk. We're selling our tickets through After Dark, which are a brilliant ticketing site. There probably will be some left available on the door, but they will be a bit more pricey.
Yes, and you don't want to chance it just in case.
No. You get there too late. Yeah,
you turn up in your glowy stuff and you can't get in.
Yeah, you can see like everyone inside having fun and stuff.
No, oh, the thought of it. Yeah. So, as well as a DJ, a recording artist, you also teach music, don't you?
I do, yes. I teach in two different modules with the Point Blank Music School. Mm-hmm. So I teach in the music industry, which is basically a great course for anyone who's going into thinking of sort of anyone from a school leaver and up. So I have students between the ages of like 17 up to 50 who want to learn and understand about the music industry, how all the different components work together, and really importantly, how you can work and make a living in the music industry. So I teach that. And I also teach record deals and branding, which is really looking at developing a record label or an artist or your idea for a music business and understanding how you can brand it, understanding how to do your marketing, obviously using social media, and really kind of get to grips with, again, and it's all about finding ways that you can have a successful long-term career in the music industry.
Because social media has changed the game for performers, hasn't
it? Oh, massively. Yeah. I mean, I'm showing my age now, but I remember when I was first DJing, recording mixtapes and posting them to promoters if I wasn't actually going to the event. Like, people watching are probably thinking, mixtapes? What are they? I'm sure you guys remember mixtapes.
I'm very familiar.
You know, it's a gramophone.
Mixtapes are quite new, aren't they?
When I learned to DJ, there wasn't even any Google or YouTube at that time. Yeah. And now we have all these amazing tools at our disposal to be able to like reach the people who love our music and you know, connect with our fans directly, which is fantastic. So social media is definitely a game changer, but also you know, it's can sometimes suck up quite a lot of your time. Sure. So it's good to kind of know where you're strong at on social media, so what you can use to really kind of, if you're an artist or a DJ, you're running a club night, how you can use social media in your area to get your music out there.
You also get a lot more truth now because of the moving in on technology. People can't deceive you as much because there's thousands of people going, actually, no, that's not right.
Well, it's very interesting actually now that, you know, we've seen sort of with Spotify coming about and all the streaming of music, the listeners now are making more informed decisions on what they want to hear because the record labels aren't prescribing what the hit should be.
Right, yeah.
The artists are now have more knowledge and understanding to put their music out, and then, you know, through Spotify has the algorithm, so you know, you might find Lizzie Curious, you like Lizzie Curious, and then they'll recommend other house music artists for you to listen to. Right. So there's this new discovery that's there as well. Mm. And yeah, it's a really exciting time.
It's a great time to be young because you can actually access thousands of songs.
Yeah, it's a great time to be a music lover of any age.
Again,
even your age.
I remember the gramophone record, you had to turn it over, you had to buy it.
Yes, you had to physically go
into a shop, talk to people.
I paid £8 for one track on vinyl.
I know,
Yes.
Tell the kids today. They go, shut up. Shut up, Grandad. Yeah. So, Pride. You also play Pride. Yes.
My favourite time of year in Pride.
Oh, mine too.
Yes. Yeah.
Hasn't it come round quick? It feels like 5 minutes ago we were talking about the Fringe, and now we're talking about August. It's not that far off.
Yes.
No, not at all.
What's happening? What's going on?
Well, this year, I've been working closely with Block, which is an amazing bar in Kemp Town.
That amazing garden.
We had a great garden party there, and I'm going to be doing another party with them on the 7th of September, but before that I'm going to be playing at the street party in Kemp Town. The slot is to be confirmed, so watch this rainbow coloured space.
I
will be there in my rainbow tutu, skipping around, spreading the love and the good vibes.
Because I absolutely love the street party. It's just so much fun.
I'm so glad we've been able to carry on with it.
Definitely.
Yeah, that's an important part.
In years gone by, it's been a little bit precarious as to whether or not it continues. I absolutely love it. I'm so excited that it can.
Well, obviously precarious then. Just
I don't know. Well, it's just one of those things where just a great Brighton institution that because of, you know, noise and things like that, it was a little bit uncertain.
Noise, it's a city, for goodness sake.
I know.
Come on, people. It's a city.
But it's fine now, and that's the main thing.
That's
it's fine now.
And it's going to be
street party,
wonderful.
And it is going to be wonderful, and hopefully it will be glorious place.
So it's going to be house music again, so various kinds of house.
Yeah, and I'll probably be mixing in quite a lot of classics. I've been very excited, so I've already been thinking about the tunes, and I'm going to have a theme of love, like in every single song that I play. Lots of sing-along, happy vibes. Curious energy.
Perfect for Pride Weekend.
Curious energy, I like that.
So, we have got 6th of July.
Yes, Bad Dog, Neon Glow Party.
We've got Pride Weekend, where you at some point will be playing your records in the street to everybody and be dancing.
Yeah.
And then, what's in September? Is you're back at Block?
We're back at Block. We're going to be doing another garden party in their gorgeous garden. It's, I don't know if you've been, I'm not sure if you've been, Jason. It's like a hint, it's like a little slice of Ibiza.
Oh, it's amazing.
Hidden in Kemp Town, like lovely whitewash walls and palm trees and great vibes. So, yes, Saturday, 7th of September, we're doing another Bad Dog garden party. Free entry. We'll be out in the garden playing lovely house music, very much kind of Balearic Ibiza sort of vibes. And then later we go inside and turn it up a bit of a notch for a bit of a nighttime shindig.
Well, hey, so in the last minute, so the Point Blank School I'm really interested in.
Yeah.
So if anybody's interested in getting into the music business, they should contact. Would they contact you?
Just search for Point Blank Music School.
Right.
I teach online, so anyone from over the world anywhere in the world can access the courses.
That's
so
fantastic,
all of them.
Though,
search for Lizzie Curious and send
me
a message.
That's amazing.
Yes.
You don't actually, again, don't have to physically.
Another
be
amazing
there.
Technological advantage.
Yes. This will sit at home.
Yeah. You can
pressing
just
buttons.
Search for me, Lizzie Curious, ask me a message about Bad Dog, Point Blank, anything.
Well,
just find me on
fantastic.
Facebook.
Well, we are going to share all of your details on our Facebook page. I'm sure the wizardry that is Latest TV has been flashing up pictures and links and everything else. Will you come back
soon?
Oh,
I would love to.
And give
Thank
us
you
an
so
update.
Much.
Thank you so much for tuning in. Thank you to Lizzie. Thank you to all of our guests. And most of all, thank you to you at home. Please join us next time. Good night.
Good night.